Welcome guys, I am Parinita. Subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to receive regular notifications regarding the computer science topics and technical job updates. Hello guys, welcome to my channel to polish your CSE concepts with me. So let's get started. In today's video we are going to learn about a very interesting and important topic, that is data warehouse architecture. You must be knowing that nowadays our data mining and data warehouse series is going on, where every day we are learning some or the other new thing regarding data mining and data warehouse. Now today we are in this video, we are going to learn in detail that what is data warehouse architecture, which are the components involved in it, and what are all these components about and what they are doing. Fine, because before learning anything about data warehouse, it is very important to know that what its architecture looks like. Fine, so here we are going to see each of these components in detail. Fine, so let's start. What happens in data warehouse architecture? What happens in the whole flow is, first of all, here you can see operational data and external data is given as input. Now we know that what happens in data warehouse, that we are getting data from various sources. Fine, now we are from various sources, we are getting bulk of data. Now whatever data we are receiving, we can broadly categorize that data into two main parts, two main categories you can say, that is operational data and external data. Now what do we mean by operational data? Whenever we are receiving any data from databases like Oracle, relational databases, non-relational databases, whatever it is there, whenever from any databases we are getting that bulk of data on which we can directly do any such operations, we can say that they are operational data. And external data means what? External data is nothing but you can say that any external link. Whenever from external sources you are getting external links, we can say that they are external data. So whenever any such type of data, different types of data, that is any bulk of data is coming inside, we are getting the data. So first of all, those data collectively go to the load manager. Now you can see here that main three types of managers we are here, we are having: load manager, query manager and warehouse manager. These three are, you can say that, the heart of this architecture. They three are very important. Now first of all, what happens whenever this bulk of data goes to the load manager? Now this load manager basically performs two important things. So the first thing is loading the data, whatever from external sources we are getting the data. So the first important task is loading the data, and secondly what it is doing is, it is doing the task of data transformation. Means, as we know, from bulk of from various different data sources we are getting bulk of data. Now the data can be of different types, like, right, as we have seen here, they can be operational data, they can be external data like links, they can be of different formats. Now what the load manager will do is, it will take all those data of different types, and whenever needed it will try to convert the all those data into one consistent format, and such a format that the data can be easily processed further. Fine, so what it will do, it will do transformation and loading the data. First of all, loading the data and doing transformation if needed. Transformation is nothing but bringing all the data into one some specific consistent format. Fine, so these tasks will be done by the load manager. Now after loading the data and transforming the data, basically we are getting three types of data in our data warehouse, that is detailed data, summarized data and metadata. Now what do we mean by detailed data? Whatever bulk of data we are having, if we see about all the details from all the data, we can say that that is detailed data. Fine, second one is summarized data. Now whenever we are taking out the summary of this detailed data, bringing out the summary means taking the main points, important points from the detailed data, we can say that that is our summarized data. Now why this summarized data is important? Okay, see this part, what is shown here, that whenever any user fires any query, gives any input or fires any query, it comes to query manager. Fine. Now what the query manager will do, it will take the query from the user. Query means anything, like in SQL we know that what we are firing the query, whenever we want to see the data, we are firing select star from database. Whenever we want to update any data, we are firing the query for update, right? So similarly, whenever any user fires any query in the data warehouse or database or in the data, whenever the user wants something from the data, what
the user can do? The user can fire the query, and that query will first of all go to the query manager. Now, what is the task of query manager? Query manager will take the query from the external user, and query manager will try to get the result out. Now, whenever the user, whenever the query manager is getting the query, if he goes to find out the result from the detailed data every time. Detailed data means, as I have already told you, detailed data means it will contain bulk of data. So if the query manager will every time go to find out the result from those bulk of data, it will be very time consuming, right? So what happens in the summarized data? We are taking the summary or the important points from the detailed data and we are storing it in summarized data. You can say that kind of it is working as cache memory. You know that in memory we are having cache memory for easier access or quicker access. The same thing happens here, that whenever the query manager receives any query, the query manager will first try to find out the result from the summarized data. And if it gets the result from the summarized data only, it will be it can give the result very quickly, fine. So that is where summarized data comes into the picture, and that is how it is very helpful. So that every time consuming, every time this query manager don't need to do so much of searching in the detailed data, so that time will be saved with the help of this summarized data, fine. So summarized data will contain the important parts or the overall summary of this detailed data. Now third one comes metadata. Now what do we mean by metadata? As we know, metadata is nothing but data about the data. So whenever whatever data regarding the data we are saving, it is known as metadata. Means we know that bulk of data is coming to our data warehouse. Metadata means saving the details, like what is the total storage of the data, or what is the timing of the data when the data is received. Timing means, we know that there is something known as timestamp. We are maintaining the timestamp, right? So maintaining the storage information, maintaining the timestamp, all those things are nothing but we can say that they are metadata. Fine. So this is the whole flow here. The importance of all the components in this part we have discussed. Now, who actually does these things, that finding the summarized data from the detailed data or maintaining the metadata, taking care of all those things? Who basically does these things? Warehouse manager. We can say that warehouse manager is the most important component that is doing or handling most of the things going on in the data warehouse. Fine. So warehouse manager is very important, who is handling those things. So these things, making or bringing summarized data from the detailed data, maintaining the metadata, these things are also mainly handled by this data warehouse manager. Now, apart from this flow, one more thing is shown here, that whatever data we are getting, like this operational data, external data, or whatever bulk of data we are getting from the data sources, first of all, what we are doing is, archive or backup of this data is kept. Like, you know that we are having Google search engine, we are searching our query there, and what Google does is it gives us lot of information based on the data it is already storing. It is already storing bulk of data, and from that data it is searching as per our search, and it is giving us the relevant answers, fine, relevant results. So in this, if we talk about Google also, it is not bringing the result only from one place. There also what happens, that Google is having multiple servers or multiple data warehouses, so that where they are like maintaining the backup of their data, because whenever we are having any big data warehouse, it is very important to backup the data for further need, whenever it is needed, or if any data is lost, we can bring out that data from any other place, fine. So in data warehouse also we are doing the same thing, that whenever we are receiving the data, first of all, archive or backup of the data is kept, and ultimately after the whole processing like this, we are ultimately giving out the information. So overall, what is happening, we are getting various types of data from the data warehouse. It is going inside the data warehouse, all these things takes place, and ultimately the external user or the third party user is getting the information. Out of the raw data, they are getting a quality information or the useful information. Fine. So I hope this is all about data warehouse architecture. I hope you have understood each component well. In case you like the video and you found it helpful, please like it. Please share it as much as possible. And if you have not subscribed the channel yet, please subscribe the channel. Thank you so much.